Hi, Alvin De Leon here, and you are watching episode 30, that's right, 30, of the 3-Minute Health Tip. In this episode, I'm going to talk about body awareness. Now, over the last 29 episodes, if you've been following me, first of all, thank you for your time, but you've also probably started to become aware of this new health perspective, this idea that we look at each person as a biological unit comprised of their psyche, the brain, and their organ, and that a lot of the symptoms that we experience can be tied to the unexpected conflicts that we subconsciously and subjectively perceive in our day-to-day lives. And that if we can really resolve those conflicts, we can resolve the symptoms that we experience. Now, I know that I've always talked about you being the expert of your body, you knowing what your body needs in order to deal with whatever symptom you're dealing with at that moment. But the one thing that I've learned over 14 years of clinical practice is that most of us have very low body awareness. That's right. Most of us don't really pay attention to our bodies and what it's doing or how it's feeling. And so a lot of people, not really surprisingly, are baffled when I say, well, what do you think you need? You know, you're the expert. What do you think your body needs to get better? And a lot of people just don't really think that they can trust themselves to know. And so they're looking for other experts to tell them what to do. Well, in this health tip, I'm going to give you 3 of the things that you can do to really enhance and increase your body awareness so you can have a greater relationship with your body and develop a greater trust in knowing what your body needs at any moment that you're dealing with any symptom. So the first step to increase your body awareness is consciousness. And I mean being conscious of your body. Like, as you're sitting there watching this right now, what is the right knee, the back of your right knee feeling like? What is your left middle toe feeling like? Bring your conscious thought to that area of the body and just experience how it feels. You know, so one of the ways that you can do this is just during your day, take a few moments to pay attention to your body. Be conscious of how your back feels, your neck, your stomach, your tongue, your fingers, your toes. You know, I tend to do this first thing in the morning. When I get up, first thing I do is be thankful that I'm alive that day, that it wasn't my last day. And then while I'm still in bed, I just take a mental note of how my body's feeling. What's my leg feeling like? What's my back feeling like? How's my head, my neck? And just do a mental scan of your body. So take some time to do that so that you can start to develop this awareness of how your body is feeling. So that's the first step, conscious awareness of your body and its parts. The second step is really spending some time in silence. I find that when we spend some time in silence and we tune out the external noises, we tend to really go inside, go within, and we become more introspective. And we start to really recognize some of the thoughts and some of the feelings that come to the surface in those moments of silence. So perhaps you're in the middle of deciding what you need to do next or what your body needs. Having moments of silence in your day can help, you know, the answer to come to the surface for you so that you will know exactly what you need to do next. So you can have those moments in organized time like meditation or your yoga practice, or it could just be walking silently alone in the woods, in your neighborhood, or like me, I like to go for long drives sometimes in complete silence with the radio off so I can just think and listen to see what comes to the surface. So the second step in increasing your body awareness, spending moments of your day in absolute silence. Now the third step is to be engaged. And I mean physically and emotionally be engaged. Be challenged, have a skill, have something that you're thinking about or physically doing that's a little bit demanding for you. I know that researcher and author Mihaly Csikszentmihalyi talks about this as the flow experience. So being in that flow really makes us appreciate what we're capable of. So whether that's playing a sport, learning a new skill, working on a puzzle or a mental challenge, it makes you start to appreciate what you're capable of, what your mind is capable of, and what your body is capable of doing under extreme pressures or demands. And so by doing these 3 things, being consciously aware of your body parts, spending some time in silence, and engaging yourself physically and emotionally or mentally, I think that you're going to develop a greater body awareness that's going to help you in knowing exactly what your body needs when it's dealing with a physical symptom or some sort of health condition. I hope that you use this health tip and tell me how it works for you. I want to thank you again for watching episode 30, and I'll look forward to seeing you at the next episode.